The Future of Geotechnics was an online event held in 2021 to engage the global geoprofessional community to think about how our profession can play a role in shaping what the world looks like in 40 years. Over the course of 2 days, we brought top researchers and professionals to talk about the role of geoprofessionals in the mitigation of climate change, adaptation to climate change, and technology, big data, and AI. Here are some of the key highlights from those events.
Climate change is one of the most complex issues that we face today.
Many of us have been affected by wildfires, droughts, levee failures, landslides, and consequences of sea level rise. The changing climate affects our built environment and is profoundly reshaping many aspects of our lives. Our profession plays an integral role in developing resilient infrastructure that can adapt to this changing climate.
Mitigation is basically controlling global temperature through reductions in greenhouse gas emissions. And for geotechnical engineers, the adaptation part really relates to the policies and actions to reduce vulnerability and impacts on human populations.
The United Nations came out with 17 sustainable development goals. What you do touches all of these.
Given the uncertainties in climate change predictions, how do we proceed to reduce risk while maintaining some flexibility in design?
There's this really innovative designed home that was constructed in the early 1980s to what it looks like today. It's just sitting out in the middle of the bay there. And the next generation of engineers are going to face with the challenges of designing for a much more rapidly changing world. Again, as sea level rises, the water table is going to rise. As the water table rises, you have a thinner, unsaturated zone. So there's going to be lesser soil storage capacity during rainy periods. Much more of the rainfall, rather than infiltrating, is going to be running off and flooding low-lying areas. And the highest sea levels would be expected to impair the performance of gravity-driven drainage systems, as well as also some gravity sewage systems.
We're at a real pivotal point in this field to make some real changes in the context of climate change. In some areas, there's no longer complete freeze back of that active layer. Permafrost is thawing both vertically and laterally. Well, all of these changes is modifying geotechnical properties of the soil and rock that we're constructing infrastructure on. Differential response of the landscape makes linear infrastructure, pipelines and roads, very challenging to design for, construct for. So where do I see the next 40 years? I think it's pretty widely accepted at this point that we are experiencing climate-driven changes to permafrost, and we're seeing the landscape respond.
So we can forecast geotechnical engineers dealing with many problems, similar to the Trans-Alaska Pipeline, of how do you isolate and protect infrastructures in the Arctic?
We need to continue to be leveraging technology, both in geotechnical characterization of permafrost in lab and field settings, new ways to map permafrost and ground ice, and improvement in infrastructure performance monitoring for decision making. We need to make more considerations in the geotechnical properties of the material prior to reaching the thawing state. So there's a lot of room for development in that area. Also, improvement in how we consider climate change, our predictions, understanding how that material is going to respond over both time and space. One of our key things that we need to be doing to address some of these challenges is adopting a more proactive approach. A proactive approach involves developing short-term goals that follow actions to achieve a long-term strategy.
So how do we adapt? Well, we adapt by considering the geosynthetic solution on every infrastructure project to ensure that the needs of the present are met, certainly, but without compromising our future together. In all of these ways, geosynthetics now are creating a sustainable benefit to our design. So we're replacing and reducing other construction materials. We're protecting limited resources. We're reducing the number of trucks that go to a site, the energy consumption, the associated CO2 emissions. We preserve the surface and groundwater, safeguard it from contamination. We're providing environmental protection and resilience, and we're providing economic growth and social welfare. The further developments of geosynthetic projects and products continue and provide a lot of innovative solutions for what's ahead of us as a design engineering community.
as geotechnical engineers, we can actually bring our normal day-to-day work to both climate change sustainability to actually solve some of these wicked challenges we have.
The key point is that climate change evaluations are inherently multidisciplinary team efforts. You're not expected to be able to know everything or do everything, but team members really need to have an understanding of the basic issues related to climate change to really contribute to the effort.
We have a responsibility to leave the place we're actually living in better for the next generation. We actually need to take on and manage our resources to actually help our communities and economies to transition in a future that our kids and their kids have the same opportunities we have.
There's a real challenge to try and figure out strategically in different parts of the world which combinations of solutions are appropriate. From a geotechnical side, the grey infrastructure is better defined and better designed than the green infrastructure. But frankly, it's the green infrastructure which is going to enable long-term performance of the grey infrastructure. And geotechnical engineers need to adapt themselves to this more multifaceted world. Unleash your natural curiosity. Remain curious, remain open to new ideas, and you will find solutions to some of these really interesting problems presented by climate change.
The increase of carbon emissions in the atmosphere leads to climate change, which impacts infrastructure, food supply, and the ability of the planet to sustain life for long term. However, population growth and economic advancement demands the use of more energy. So we need to find ways to balance the two, decrease carbon emissions, and still meet the new energy needs by creating the circular carbon economy.
Times are changing, folks. The peaks for the world soil mechanics took place in the 50s and the 60s, foundation engineering in the 70s and 80s. Now when we look at the words that are really popping up are all related to sustainability, climate change, carbon geological storage.
Would energy geostructures play a significant role in the city's transformation towards a carbon-free environment? Are geotechnical engineers expected in the future to have a more increased role in the energy transition?
We have an opportunity there, because if we have an interaction with the ground, we can exchange heat with the ground, and we can go beyond the structural role and try to add another role, which is that of heat exchanger. If you're able to thermally activate the tunnel and to connect it to the buildings on top, and you can do this for many, many kilometers, then basically you can use this tunnel almost as a distribution system and connect the heat you get from the tunnel directly to the building on top. It's a topic where geotechnical engineers have the knowledge and have the power to go into it. We need to renew and reinvent infrastructures, and we refer to new design infrastructure, but also on existing infrastructure.
One renewable does not exclude the other. It's also about integration of the renewables in the future.
There are revolutions taking place, and there are actual paradigm shifts taking place in our field. It's time to explore them and to embrace them. For our field to remain vibrant, we must be relevant. And furthermore, it's our responsibility to society. We must be relevant. Imagine if we come together as a community from around the world and we put together all the information that we have about soils, information that we have collected throughout the last 100 years, and we can link index properties and engineering properties to provide an AI tool for anybody, anywhere in the middle of Latin America or Africa or in downtown New York City, to put together the best design properties to feed these nowadays very complex numerical models.
Recent advancement in technology has shaped all parts of our lives. The question is, how will that impact geotechnical engineering?
AI and machine learning are closer to you today than you might think they are. You just need to take that little extra step to add them to your toolkit. Anyone can develop a model, but I think it takes a good geotechnical engineer with subject matter expertise to create a physically meaningful model.
Engineers are entrusted by clients to solve problems because they have the right education, experience, and judgment. We as engineers develop expertise to be trusted to solve particular problems for others.
And then finally, for the engineer, I think the main task is to learn the necessary skills to handle, evaluate, and manipulate data. Most of it is about the data. If we don't have good data, we're not gonna make good predictions and everything else that follows from it. So the questions we should ask ourselves is, are we collecting the right kind of data? Are the measurements that we're taking actually, are they physical parameters which are describing our problem? Every time you get new data, you can repeat that learning process and update your models. You're trying to prevent data losses. And by storing data in a centralized database with a rigorous quality assurance system for any data that ends up in that database, you can actually come a long way into making AI and machine learning a reality.
I think in geotechnical engineering, we're always going to be working with the data deficit. Our design, even if sampling improved 100 times from what we have now, there's always going to be a lot of human decision making involved in even using AI and even using machine learning. I would like to see AI moving away from exclusively looking at interpreting data, but helping it to help us understand how we make human decisions and then empowering human decision making.
Human coming in, making sense of the decision from the machine is important. My desire would be that this entire learning loop cannot be a black box. Because if the engineer cannot understand how the solution is obtained, the engineer is only left with saying yes or no, with no understanding.
And then the computer vision can replace manpower to conduct a smart inspection and monitoring of geostructural system in a faster and relatively precise way. It can capture crucial behavior and advanced digital twin technology together with the smart sensing techniques can significantly improve safety risk management. The future work is how to use huge data to evaluate the safety and health of infrastructure. So this is the challenge and also is our future work.
Thank you for attending this series of presentations and lectures.
The purpose of this event was to inspire you to think beyond your own borders. This is just the beginning of the conversation. We hope that you can join us in shaping our work, our profession, and our future together.